नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बेटिया। जय भीम डॉक्टर राकेश शर्मा, प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जनरल मेडिसिन फिलोसॉफी विद्यापीठ लंदन यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। और टुडे सेशन इज स्टूडेंट प्लस फिलोसॉफी जनरल इंटरप्रिटेशन चैप्टर सेकंड व्हिच वी बी गोइंग टू पार्ट सेकंड। द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म आल्सो गेट एक्सटर्नल सब्सटेंसेस एंड देयर फोर्सेस इनटू इटसेल्फ, yet they are not the sole cause of its emotions, but only for the nourishment of the constantly active things. Substances taken into the organism from without remain passive within the organism, while the organism towards them is active. Food does not pass spontaneously into the blood, nor is the blood changed spontaneously into bile or urine. But these things occur by virtue of living, intelligent, reciprocal causes and effects residing and taking place within the organism, according to determinate specific laws. Science gets its knowledge of life from a examination of the facts of observation and experience in connection with the laws which express the form of their necessity in accordance with which they occur. The facts and the laws stand together with the same objective view in pondering the continuation of two different states of the same living body, each has health and disease. The law of causation teaches that no internal effect can arise without any external cause, and that the effect itself may in turn become a cause of further changes. The law of wish inertia in activity teaches that all internal changes of bodies in nature are the result of an external cause, for without this all bodies would remain in the same state in which they were placed. The state of the body must be known before any change in it can be known. The cause or reason of the state of the body, therefore, are the conditions under which it can be changed by any external cause. So there is two states, the healthy state and the diseased state. Both states are very different, and these are developed from the some causes, some conditions. In medical science and especially in therapeutics, when unfairness must be made between the two relations of state and change. According to these two laws, since the action of the curative agent introduced into the body has external causes for the purpose of changing a state of disease into a state of health, the purpose of administering the medicine is to change the state, change the disease state into the healthy state. Can only be determined by paying due regard to the condition of age, sex, constitution, predisposition, as manifested by symptoms or phenomena. Regard must always be had for the differences which exist between that which is constant and unchangeable in the life of organism and that which is changeable. The constant and unchangeable are the laws of its specific form, as shown in cells, connective tissue. Forms are transmitted by parents. The changeable are the chemical and physical properties of these constituents of the organism, which are derived from the external world and the functioning of the organism itself. Pathological form elements must be like the psychological, since the organism can form nothing within itself against its own unchangeable laws. Two things thus constitute disease. First, the qualities of the organism, which constitute the conditions for the disease. Second, the external causes of the disease. So, two things are necessary for disease to be born. One is the qualities of the organism. इस ऑर्गेनिज्म के अंदर डिस्पोजिशन होना चाहिए, वो सक्सेसिवली होनी चाहिए मॉलिक्यूल होने के लिए, डिक्रीज इम्यूनिटी, डिक्रीज रेसिस्टिंग पावर, डिक्रीज वाइटल एनर्जी फॉर द डिजीज एंड द एक्सटर्नल कॉजेज ऑफ डिजीज। तो एक्सटर्नल कॉज एक्सटर्नल कॉजेज होनी चाहिए तो डिजीज प्रोड्यूस करे, जब तक दोनों मिलेंगे तब जाके डिजीज स्टार्ट। forms of disease also obey fixed law of constants. Instead of seeking the causes and character of its presenting form of disease only, in that which is immediate, we should seek the more distant causes which have manifested themselves in the course of disorders and diseases which have leading up to the present form. So the basic or unchangeable force of matter, which are the properties of its masses, are divided into forces of repulsion or attraction. Both may operate at a distance by contact, since every action is nature is a mutual action between bodies. Such as basic force does not belong to the body alone, but belong to it in the ratio of its relations to other bodies. Here we find that the like repel and the unlike attract each other. This session powered by Digital Workshop 2.0 with Vidyapeeth Women's University. That is my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box to resolve. Thank you.